Hey guys, it's Krishanti with Krishanti.com, bringing you videos about psychic development and spiritual and personal growth. And this week's video is part four in a four-part series on working with your aura. So in the other parts of the series, I spoke about how to ground your aura, drain energy out of it, how to bring your aura in around your body, so that you can just kind of keep your energy to yourself and not be as affected by the energy of other people. I made another video about how to make your aura very big and expansive so you can hold a presence in a room, so you can really get attention and be confident in a space. And this video is about filling your aura with colored light. So before I get into it, if you're into this topic, come on over and subscribe, because I do new videos every week and I'd love to see you here. And now, the thing about the aura that I've talked about in the other videos in this series is it's very responsive to what you want it to be, what you intend. Of course, if you're in a meditative mode and you're really focusing, it's going to be more powerful. But you can do these things on the go and on an as-need basis. Like, for example, if you're around someone really annoying or someone that's like an energy vampire, you can just suck your aura in. Or if you're having to make a presentation and you want to be heard by everyone in that conference room, you can just imagine you're expanding your aura and it's filling up the entire conference room and you are owning that space. So when it comes to working with light, those of us who are clairvoyant, which I am, it's not just a way of being. Clairvoyance is like a school of thought as well, which is that everything boils down to like a symbolic image and or a color. So when you're filling your aura with color, or you're intending to fill it with color, that color can affect a change. It can shift the vibration. It can change your energy. And different colors mean different things. Now, I apologize. To go into a whole color theory thing would be like an entire course in and of itself. But what I will say is that if you let your intuition guide you, which, by the way, happens in every session when I do an energy healing on someone and I ask them about what color they want to set their crown chakra to, they know like right away what color they need. And it's like an intuitive thing. That's all I have to say. If you intuitively settle into what color your aura needs or what color is best for you, you'll be on the right track. You don't think about it too much. And then you imagine you fill your aura with that color. It will shift your energy and your vibration, and other people will notice. And I don't want you to get hung up on the meanings of different colors, but many people who are skilled in the healing arts say that pink, for example, is a very regenerative energy. It's also healing. They say that the color green is very, very healing and restorative. And there are so many different shades of these colors as well, right? A beautiful blue can be very spiritual and very therapeutic. What I've had fun with, and I actually have a meditation, if you want to check it out at krishanti.com, is filling it with diamond sparkles. It's just a beautiful, sparkling, radiant light. And that said, just filling your aura with the energy of sunlight is very healing. And it's also very protective. That sunlight energy, that brilliant, beautiful light, if you just fill it up from head to toe, and as I mentioned in the other videos in this series, imagine it. It's all you have to do. Make sure you're imagining it going above your head, all around your body. The light changes, I think, when I do that. Below your feet, back, front, all over, you're just in a cocoon of whatever color light you'd like to be in. And you know what's really fun is you can also just breathe that light in and imagine as you breathe it in, it's coming up and going out and radiating throughout your body. And again, it can have a healing effect. It can have a calming effect. It can have a sparkly, beautifying effect that other people notice. So play with the colors that come to you. play with that energy and notice how the people in your life react, because people do respond when you work with your aura. I've seen it over and over again. I've taught it in classes where everybody after the class went out, came back and reported, like, what, you know, the next weekend, it was a two-part thing, came back and reported like what happened when they worked with their auras. It's really fun. But, you know, one thing I didn't talk about in the other videos is the aura, because it's so close to the body, you can see disease in the aura if you're looking at it clairvoyantly before it manifests in the physical body. So by breathing in color and light energy and sending it throughout your aura, you can heal whatever your aura's got in there before it comes into your body. Now that's more intense energy work, but that's the kind of power your aura has and the power you have when you work with your aura. If you want to learn more about this, I have so many resources at krishanti.com. I've got psychic protection classes, intro to psychic development, a video course. I have tons of meditations, tons of other workshops that I've made over the years, and I would love for you to partake in all of it. Also, though, if you sign up for my mailing list, you'll get a free gift and you'll be notified when I start to do live classes again, because that's on my radar. I think it would be so fun to get all of us together in a group setting doing a live group workshop, even if it has to be over Zoom. So check all that out. But before I go, and I know I'm saying a lot and it's the spiel to come to my website and everything, please share if you do these techniques in the comments and let us know how it goes. Let us know and let me know too if you've done work on your aura and how it's affected your life. I think the more we talk about this stuff, the better, because we're normalizing it. This should be normal and natural. We're all energetic beings. We all have auras. We can all work with our auras and make positive changes in our lives. So with that, thank you so much for watching and for being here, and I'll see you next time.